Welcome back. We're here with Jane Barlow Christensen, and we're going to talk about the future of beauty and herbals and natural, just natural what?
Natural living.
Absolutely. Happiness. Amy's ready. We're going to be naturally happy.
Yeah.
Jane, talk to us. Barlow Herbals has been around a long time. And they're probably the best kept secret.
Yeah, well, so my dad was a botanist, and he started it at Barlow Herbal when I was 14.
Wow.
So 43 years ago.
That's a long time.
So he passed away 20 years ago, and I've been carrying on his work for a really long time.
Amazing.
Not just his herbals, but now, the last 10 years, I've been developing a lot of my own formulations.
Tell us about that. What's new? Oh, what are you developing?
Well,
how is it helping what we need today to be better tomorrow?
Okay, where do I start?
Anywhere.
Right? Yeah, so as I'm getting older, I get all these questions from people that ask me, how do you stay off of prescription drugs? Mm-hmm. How do you take care of your skin? Mm-hmm. How do you take care of your heart? All the things that affect us, not just as women, but as men. Everyone gets affected by. We all think we're a victim of aging and a victim of our genes, and we're not.
No, we're not. That's actually kind of liberating to think about.
It is. It's true.
Yeah. Well, it actually just means that it's all our fault then.
Yeah,
well,
yeah, that's true. Wait, I take it back. It's not liberating.
You can look at it that way, or you can look at it this way. You get to be responsible.
Okay.
So your health depends on two things, really. And this is a whole other topic we could go into, but it depends on your environment, the environment you put your body in, what you eat, what you drink, how much stress you have, how much sleep do you get, how much water do you get, how much love and forgiveness you have in your life. That's all a part of your health. And then your perception, your belief system. If you believe that you're a victim of your genetic expression because everybody in your family gets whatever, then your belief system is making your body express. And this is a whole topic that's hard for people to wrap their head around.
You know what? I've always like intrinsically believed in that biofeedback. Like I have always known, I'm like, what I tell myself is a version of reality, and it's a lot more likely to happen if I'm believing it
just
myself.
Look at yourself within your family structure. I mean, I come from a family of medical doctors.
Yeah.
And so, and my dad was the pharmacist. So we had a whole built-in network of if you're sick, go see Cousin Steve, he'll give you the prescription, go see Dad, and then you're taken care of.
Right.
But it never worked for me. So I kept seeking and seeking and seeking.
Because it didn't feel right to you probably too. And see, then I grew up with the opposite. You know, there's
no doctors. No,
well, my dad was a doctor. He was a doctor. He had a PhD, but it was very different.
Right.
It was like herbs and a poultice and go pull this out of the
the
side of the house where we grow the comfrey. Go grab me a handful of that. And it was just a really different way to grow up, which you don't appreciate. Like none of us appreciated it when we were growing up. And now we're all like, oh, wow. You know, Dad was, I mean, we've known this for
really
a long time as adults now, but you kind of go, what a gift.
It is such a gift, you know, and it's interesting because I have a brother who is a doctor. He's a dermatologist. I have a brother who's a doctor in the dental industry. We come from a, you know, family of very strict believers of traditional medicine.
Yeah.
And it's been really interesting to see, like, my son was having some, like, gut problems. And the solution from traditional medicine was take a probiotic, and I was so impressed and surprised that they're finally starting to see some of what your dad and you and your family have been saying for a long time.
Well, it takes a long time for these things to come around. Like gut health has been important since the beginning of time, and people don't realize that the foods that they're eating, and then prescription drugs, which have their place. I'm not totally anti-prescription drug, but if you take antibiotic, even one round of an antibiotic, it wipes out all your gut flora. And unless you replace it, then you're leaving your system open.
Well, so, 4 years ago, I was diagnosed with liver failure. And
Holy
we
God.
Tracked it back to antibiotic toxicity as a child.
Oh my
because
gosh.
I was sick all the time, and every month I was on a battery of antibiotics.
Yeah.
Nobody knew to replace.
Right.
Nobody knew that the whole microbiome was going to be displaced and malformed. And it took a year to really go down and clean it back out and start again. So when I talk to people like you who have been into the natural and the herbal and the high quality remedies,
Yeah.
That's the stuff that people need to know about.
Yeah, and one of my favorite things that I love to tell people is I feel so confident in my ability to take care of myself and my family mm-hmm. with so many issues. Because mm-hmm. I think that's what happens when people start looking at natural health and especially herbal remedies. There's so much out there. How do they find a good source? How do they find what fits for them? Because everyone mm-hmm. is a little bit different. Mm-hmm. And then how do they have the confidence, like if I get an infection, how do I have the confidence to go, well, I'm going to do this and I'm going to do this mm-hmm. that's herbal, rather than go, well, what would happen if I do this herbal and I mess up something and mm-hmm. I die or I,
yeah, because you know, people you are afraid. You go to the doctor yeah. and you say, okay, what do yeah. you want me to do? And they say, I've already done my herbal thing and it's yeah. in this pill. Right?
Yeah.
Or, but then if you're like trying to do it yourself, like
yeah.
go out and get the handful of comfrey, I'd be like, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
First of all, what is comfrey?
Yeah,
right. Second of all.
Yeah. Well, comfrey is a bone mender. So comfrey, you can make a poultice literally and put it on a broken bone. Now you still need to have your bones set.
Yeah.
You can't just go, I'm not going to go to the doctor and
right.
not mm-hmm. take care of that. But comfrey in a poultice actually soaks in through the skin and nourishes the skin and mends yeah. the bone. It's
oh
a bone
my gosh.
Mender.
How interesting.
Yeah.
So with your website, obviously
yeah.
we could talk about this for hours, and I
yeah.
want to talk about this for hours.
Yes, yes, yes,
and,
yes.
But on your website, do you have these remedies as well as, like I see here, some skin and soap products?
Yeah. So I have a whole group of almost all my dad's remedies. Mm-hmm. He didn't do hundreds of them. He mm-hmm. did a very small group of about 25.
Mm,
so, which is good because there's not, I mean, we're in a society where there are hundreds of diseases and issues, and
mm-hmm.
the human biology is not that complicated.
Mm-hmm.
We get infections, we get, you know, viruses and funguses and parasites, and we mm-hmm. get, you know, our body expresses all kinds of things, but mm-hmm. but we've complicated it because it's so monetized by the mm-hmm. medical industry. So I have my dad's stuff on my website, and I also have, the last 10 years I've started developing my own formulas because I've had people that are like I said earlier, what do you do to
yeah.
stay healthy? So I have a line that's called Jane Health, mm-hmm. which is really super fun. My grandkids think I'm famous because I have my name on products. No, it's so
amazing.
Cute. No, it's so cute. In fact, when I told them I was coming down here to be on this with you guys, my six-year-old granddaughter said, you're going to be on TV? Are you famous, Grandma?
Oh, my gosh. What is her name?
Her name's Hazel.
Hi, Hazel.
Oh, my God.
We're so glad that you're watching.
Oh, she's going to love that.
She will.
She's going to love that. She's super cute. But so this serum, this is my skin serum. So I have eight sisters besides uh-huh. myself. And a few years before I turned 50, I decided I need to start taking better care of my skin.
Mm-hmm.
So I started playing around with oils and butters. And this was never meant to be a product. This was mm-hmm. meant to be just something that I'm in my little lab with all my stuff.
Yeah.
And I did about 20 formulations.
Wow.
Like, and I would use all my sisters as guinea pigs.
I
would send them a bottle.
Glowing skin.
It's pretty fantastic. So what happened is after I got this perfect recipe, so there's all kinds of oils, all kinds of butters, and then there's six herbs that are infused into an oil and then put in the serum. I mean, this is
Which
really
one is
special.
This? Which, is
so
it the
there's,
same?
So it's the same base, and
mm-hmm.
there's actually, I have four different scents. So the first, for 10 years, I've had lavender and lemongrass.
Mm-hmm.
And just this last week, I brought out Lang Lang and bergamot.
Ooh, wow. Can I smell?
So these are both,
and
I brought some for you.
I've been waiting. I'm going to show the camera first so they can see. This is what you need to buy.
Well, this is, so let me tell you, this is really different if you're used to putting lotions on your skin and you're not used
mm-hmm.
to putting oil.
Mm-hmm. Oil is really different, isn't
oil
it?
Oil is very different.
Would you like some?
And you might not be able to smell
one?
This.
Which one is
so
it?
So put it on the back. Put it on, that's fine.
Okay.
I'll just put it
right
back here.
Yeah. So like
here, I'll pop it on you. Here.
Pop it on me.
I'll pop it on you.
I'm
there
excited
you go.
About
okay.
this.
Okay. So let's see, which one is that? That
this
one
is the
that's Lang Lang.
That smells good.
So it not only smells good, but Lang Lang and bergamot are both really nourishing for your skin.
Mm-hmm.
And just help smooth out skin color, protect you against skin cancer.
Mm-hmm.
Just it nourishes your skin on a cellular level.
Oh, this got feels healthy.
Isn't
yes.
that nice?
Oh, yeah.
Let's put this on your other
so
hand.
There's no chemicals in here and there's no preservatives.
This is bergamot.
That's mm-hmm. bergamot. So bergamot is known as a beauty oil.
Mm-hmm.
And it's So
if I lather oil. Myself in this, I will be beautiful.
You will literally glow because you're
strong.
You will be oiled up. No, it's
okay, awesome.
It's funny because sometimes I'll come to bed.
You want some?
It's funny because I'll like rub it on my face at night and my neck, and then I'll like rub it on my arms, you know, because I have some on my hands.
Oh, yeah.
And I'll come to bed. I'm like to my husband, don't touch me yet, because I'm still hasn't soaked all
the beauty oil is soaking in.
I have to let the beauty absorb within.
But at least I smell good. It's not like
it does. It smells. It smells wonderful.
It's wonderful.
And do they mix together well? Because
these two
like
do.
Mm-hmm.
And
they're mixed.
Oh, lovely.
They're lovely.
It's very refreshing.
Yeah. So this is just something that was fun. It's not medicinal, mm-hmm. but people need to think about this. Everything you put on your skin mm-hmm. ends up inside your body.
That's right.
So people need to be very careful mm-hmm. about what they put on their
Absolutely.
Skin.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And so. I find that and we'll do this, but if I have an oil like this, I mix it with my body lotion.
Yeah, and I do that sometimes too for my legs and my arms.
That's a good idea.
So what is the deal with oils though? I mean, they call it a dry oil, so you don't feel greasy after, like once it absorbs,
well, see, look,
it's not greasy anymore.
It's you just barely put this on a minute ago, and look, it's almost, you can't even see it. Yeah. Well, it's because there's nothing in there to act as a barrier. Like if you mm-hmm. were to put petroleum jelly on your skin, mm-hmm. it would not do that.
Right,
it would sit
right
on
there.
Top
True,
of your skin.
It
would sit
so
there.
So this just goes, you have layers of skin.
Got
and
it.
It's,
okay, so
got
our
it.
Producers told us that we're mm-hmm. out of time, but tell us about the soaps real quick.
Okay, well,
to ignore them.
This is okay. Well, this is just I make all my own homemade soap, uh-huh. and I give every.
Can I show the camera?
Yeah. So this is what happens. Every.
She's our Vanna White.
I can totally tell you're a good Vanna White.
Thank you.
So basically, every time someone places an order, we send them a free gift.
Oh,
and
that's wonderful.
Either a bar of soap or some homemade lip balm.
That's
but
so
this
pretty.
Is just
honestly, this looks so pretty.
It, yeah,
like you can see
around.
On the
yeah.
back here.
Yeah,
it's so pretty. Okay, so tell us your website again, so we
okay,
can all
so
go order.
Okay, so it's barlowherbal.com.
Okay,
so BARLOWHERBAL.com.
Okay,
perfect. Yeah,
and wonderful.
We're just gonna send our viewers there to find you.
Cool.
Thank
yeah.
you so much for joining us.
Thank
and thank you.
You
for bringing fun things to play with. We
You're
love
welcome.
Toys.
So I have
really
soap for you both.
It. Okay,
and serum for you both.
Thank you. Thank you. So next time you
thank
see
you.
Us, we're gonna be.
You're already
You'll
glowing.
Let us
I can't
know
even imagine.
If we're glowing, okay? Thank you so much, and stay with us. We'll be right back.